So why did we create this podcast, A House Built on Sand? It's something that's near and dear to Jabril's and my heart, and it's something we want to share with you. But I'll let Jabril talk first, and then I'll pipe in as we go along. But it's really something that you need to think about as a person and how you go through your life.
Yes. So for some of you might understand this this phrase, and some of you not. Some of my Christian brothers and sisters will surely understand this because it comes out of Matthew 7:24. And it's something that Jesus was talking about. It's a parable that Jesus was talking about after his Sermon on the Mount, right? And if I may, I'm just going to read a little piece for you before I explain to it from King James Version, Matthew 7:24-27. And in it, Jesus says, "Therefore, whoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man, which built a house upon a rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house. And it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. And everyone that heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them not shall be likened unto a foolish man, who built the house upon a sand. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell, and great was the fall of it." In other words, if you can use that as an allegory too, you can build a house upon a sand, but if you don't have a good foundation, that it will fall and it will sink. Just as you can build a house on sand, you can build your life on sand. And what does it mean to build your life on sand? When you don't have a good foundation, when you don't have a good structure, when you don't have a good understanding, you can build up your life and you can have a lot of material things and you can have a lot, you can be caught up in consumerism. But in the end, you feel empty. You feel a hole in your heart. You feel that you're missing something. And some people try to fill that hole with sex. Some people try to fill that hole with drugs. Some people try to fill that hole with liquor. Some people try to fill that hole with just buying more stuff. And they keep shoveling stuff into that hole and shoveling stuff in that hole. And the more stuff they shovel in the hole gets bigger and they're never satisfied. And then they reach a point in their life where they're trying to figure out what is it all worth. And that's what we're trying to answer now with this saying about a house built on sand, right? We're trying to ask you, is your life built on sand or is your life built on a strong foundation? And how do we live in this finite life? How do we live this mortal life and get through it where we're satisfied? And in the end, what is our purpose in this life? Is our purpose in this life is to gather more stuff, or our purpose in this life is to get and know the reason why we're here, to get and know and get closer to our creator or no creator? You know, that's what life is all about. And that's what this podcast is all about. We're going to ask and answer, hopefully, some questions that people have and that we have about trying to make it through this life, to try to understand why we're here, to try to understand where we're going. You know, when the Greeks would go into the Temple of Delphi, on the top is a saying that they got from the ancient Egyptians, "Know thyself." Or as Shakespeare said, "To thyself, through thy own self, be true." It's by looking inside that you find the true religion. It's by looking inside that you find the true answers. But also by looking inside, you find the scariest things that you can ever see in your life. And that's why most of us don't do it. I used to always ask my students one question: who are you? If you don't know who are you, you don't know who your creator is. And that's the question we're going to try to answer in these podcasts, also with a little fun and talking about some things that, you know, are more current, like the election and everything else that's going on. But that's the question that we must ask ourselves: who are we? And hopefully we, myself and Mark, can help you find that answer and help ourselves, more importantly, find that answer too.
Yeah. Thank you. And just to add a couple things to it is, you know, Jabril and I have lived a life, and there are consequences to decisions. You know, a lot of times those consequences are immediate, but sometimes you don't see the consequence of your decision for 10 or 20 years. And that's why it's so important to talk to people that are older, that have lived the life, so that you can learn from them instead of having to go through that experience yourself. And I think that's one other thing that we want to share with you, because life is all about choices and making good choices consistently. And we want to help you make good, consistent choices. And with that, that will help you build a strong foundation for your life instead of overextending yourself and collapsing, or instead of, stepping on people as you're climbing the corporate ladder, you know, because those people will remember it when you start to come back down. All these different things that you don't think about, especially when you're young and you have all these exciting ambitions and dreams and ideas that you want to put into place, you need to think about how you can do it in your life and balance your life, balance your relationships, and balance your role in the community so that you're going to be a benefit to everybody and not do something that's going to benefit solely yourself.
Yeah.
So, Go ahead.
Well, I was going to say that is so true. And, you know, this is not something that Mark or I are trying to convince you about or to tell you about. You know, there's something wrong that's going on right now. So many people are on opioids. So many people are on depression medicine. So many people feeling that there's something wrong in life, but they don't know what. And when you in that mode, you think it's only happening to you, but it's happening to other people too. And people, you know, are trying to figure out, why am I here? Why is all this stuff getting to me? Why is all this stuff happening to me? It's not only happening to you, it's happening to all of us, right? And once you realize that you're not here alone, that you're not going through these struggles alone, that helps you. That helps you understand things. That helps you understand how to try to get out of these negative feelings. And that's all this is all about. This is a podcast that we're going to have fun and we're going to talk, but we're going to talk about serious things too. And we're going to talk about things about life and about this, about things that are seen and unseen. Because life is more than about our five senses. Mm-hmm. Life is more about the empiricisms, about how to get through objectively, about what our senses tell us, when our senses lie to us constantly. So, you know, stick with us. You know, like I said, we're going to have a little of this information, a little of that information, and hopefully it's interesting. And, you know, you'll give us comments and feedback and, you know, let us know which way you want us to go. And we're going to talk to you, and we're going to talk to each other, and we're going to try to figure out this thing, like I said, that we call a mortal finite life. And hopefully, you know, it'll be interesting for all of us.
So I hope you'll join us, Jabril and I, on A House Built on Sand, and listen to our live streams and our podcasts. Take care and have a good day.
Peace.